Phillips with Tormach. Today I'm going to show a quick setup using a Kress high-speed spindle in a right angle attachment. Here's the right angle attachment. When we mount the right angle attachment, it clamps to the spindle nose, this. And then what we're going to do is indicate this surface here, this machine surface, where the Kress spindle clamps onto, to make sure that the head is, or the right angle attachment, square with our machine axes. That's pretty good. There's a little bit of a lip on the edge of the hole where the indicator hopped, but the sidewalls of the where the it's going to clamp on the nose of the Kress is true. So we'll finish tightening our clamp. Double check. Now to find the center of our workpiece, I'm going to use a end mill shank and a piece of paper. You just slide the paper between your workpiece, and this could be a dowel pin, end mill shank, whatever you have handy. And you just keep moving your table until you feel a light drag on the paper with the, between the tool and the workpiece. Paper moves free. Right there, you gotta tug it a little bit. We'll zero our y-axis. Do the same on the back side. Click in the box, divided by two. Now we have our y-axis center. And then you could do the same for Z. And then you'd have the center of your workpiece, or wherever you've programmed it from. The one other thing that you're gonna wanna do, you're changing the work plane in which you're working. So if you're programming at the controller, you're gonna wanna make sure you're using the right work plane. G17 is your normal XY work plane when you've got a tool in the spindle itself. When you're using the right angle attachment, you're going to want to use a G19 because you're going to be machining in the YZ plane. If we're doing straight line moves, it's not that important, but if you're doing any arcs, the only way it turns out is if you're in the right work plane. For straight line and positioning moves, it's not as critical. But if you're going to be doing any type of arcs, your radius centers require that you're in the correct work plane. If you're using CAM software, It should flip it automatically for you. What you're going to want to use a high-speed spindle in the right angle attachment. If you got some light cuts, if you have real long work pieces that you can't machine on the end, if you can't stand them up on your mill, because here all you got to do is clamp it in the vise, have enough room to get your spindle to the end of the workpiece, and it could be hanging out the other end of the machine, you know, however long, as long as you got it supported.
That's it.
That's it.